Hey guys, Andy here, and welcome to my April 2020 update video, part two, coming up. Alright, I'm recording. Hey gang, Andy here. Welcome once again to my April 2020 update video, part two. So yeah, as we always do with these update videos, we're gonna go over some personal life stuff as well as YouTube stuff. So breathe in that good ass prana. And as always, let's just jump right into it. And let's start off with some YouTube stuff. I know you guys have probably been missing the live streams and been wondering where the heck is the old Andy Sansamadeshta. The reason I haven't been live streaming lately is because my mobile data has been throttled for the rest of the month, presumably. It pretty much makes doing anything online, you know, impractical beyond maybe checking Gmail or something like that. And even then it's 50-50. So I'm pretty much just gonna be waiting until beginning of May to resume live streaming. But moving forward, I'll probably have to reduce the amount of times I stream. So whereas before I did it pretty much daily, I think this time around I'll probably have to make it either weekly or maybe twice a week at the most, until I get newer living accommodations, which we'll be getting into in the personal life section. And as far as the editing tutorials goes, that's kind of falls under the same category as well, because I want to have a nice quiet space to record the voiceover. I've toyed with the idea of maybe doing like voiceless tutorials and just having me like do the things and maybe have text pop-ups or something like that. But I want the tutorials to have a fairly consistent format. So I don't want to, you know, maybe put out a couple tutorials that are voiceless, and then, you know, once I get the private space, get back into voiced over tutorials. I think it's probably best just to wait until I get a private place to where I can record once again. So hey, it's Andy from the future, and after I got done recording this video, I decided to actually go ahead with the text-based video editing tutorials just for the meantime, so that way I can still make some good tutorials, and then once I get the private room, then we'll be resuming the normal voiceover tutorials. So anyway, back to the update. And probably the biggest story that I gotta share as far as YouTube stuff goes is that I finally got my computer back. So it came back about a week or so ago from the Asus store. Just as soon as I got the computer back and the monitor was working, it stopped working once again. So I decided, fuck it, and just went out and bought an external monitor, and just been rocking that ever since, and it's been working fine. But it does limit, obviously, the usage of the laptop. I can't exactly take it with me to Starbucks. Not that there's any Starbucks open right now, but you know, you guys know what I'm saying. It does kind of reduce the mobility of being able to use it. But in any event, I will be working on my back catalog of stuff that I had recorded several months ago. Of just stuff I never really got around to, either due to school, or due to the laptop being in the shop, or just whatever the case. I'm going to be working on that in the next coming weeks. So be sure to stay tuned for some of that upcoming content. Yeah, let's move on to some personal life stuff. As I said, I'm going to be moving into a new private space. I'm going to be moving at the end of May. I've been keeping an eye on this guest house a couple towns over. Really like the vibe of the place. It's actually really close to the university I want to go to after Lakeland, Temple University, Japan. So if I do get accepted out there, then, you know, the commute will be really fast. But even if I don't get accepted out there, you know, just being able to stay in a private room for a couple months is fine. Yeah, I think it's gonna be really nice to have my own private room once again, so I can, you know, have my own little studio space and do it all up and all that fun stuff. So I can do these, like, you know, video editing tutorials is the big one, but also doing, you know, these little update videos, so I'm not having to worry about, you know, weather conditions or people being around making a noise or whatever the case may be. You know, I can just sit down, record whenever. And I can also do live streams from there as well, so I don't have to worry about, you know, mobile signal or anything like that, because I believe that guest house has Wi-Fi, but I have to check. I'm primarily doing it just for my own mental health, basically. I really like having my own little private space, and where I'm living now kind of sort of has that, but because the space is so limited, I'm basically sleeping on my bed and working on my bed, and that's about all I have space for, really. So it's really hampering my creativity and just my ability to get shit done, basically. So I can't wait to move to the new space, and it's gonna be a lot of fun. And it's a smaller guest house than the one I'm at now, so there's less people there. So that's gonna be nice. And I'm looking forward to cooking at home once again, because I'll be honest, I've been spending like way too much eating out, and that shit ain't healthy for you anyway. If you guys are wondering about what's going on with Kelowna Chan World Tour, we'll say pretty much what it is on the news, just state of emergency, Kinku Jitai. But as you can see, there's, you know, kids and shit running around, so it's not very heavily enforced right now. They're basically doing some lockdowns with businesses, and that's kind of how they're pursuing people to not, you know, stay outside. You know, the main differences that I've noticed is that, you know, past 8 p.m., you can't dine anywhere. It's all takeout from there. And some restaurants have switched to just entirely takeout. And it's also the case with some combinis as well. Lawson's won't let you do it anymore either. Pretty much the only place I gotta go is Family Mart. I know you guys are probably thinking, well, Andy, why are you dining out anyway? Shouldn't you be staying at home? You know, stay inside and be safe and stuff like that. And yeah, I definitely do agree with it. But, you know, considering my living situation, I find it's actually a lot more dangerous for me to eat at home than it is to eat out, because there's more people in the guest house. They're in a much denser environment, a lot more close. So yeah, that's pretty much all I got to say in this little update vid, and I'll be sure to keep you guys posted as things change. And that said, this is Andy-san, signing for now, and as always and forever, we'll see you next time. Catch you later, guys. Bye.